Hello, everybody. I am so glad that you are here. And today, we're going to learn about Chromedics. Chromedics is the program that I created so that I could teach people how to speak. How will we learn it? Well, we will practice. We will learn colors, because it's all about colors. And we will learn what those colors mean. And then we will work on your own difficult words. So, shall we start? Yes. Okay. Thank you. That's what I like. It's a speech class, so let's go. Okay, now you all have these color cards, right? Because, you know, I started this program on pencil and paper. That's the way it was originally done. And we'll talk about it at the end of the class, but we are making a new application for tablets, for all kinds of tablets. And I mean, I'm really, really excited about that. But the principle is still the same. Okay? So you have your color cards. Let's go with, I'm not even going to show you the name of it, but what is the name of this color?
Red.
Right, right. It's exactly, it's red. And what I've done is say, okay, when you see this red color, you think of the vowel sound. And the vowel sound in that word, red, is eh, right? Eh. How about this one? What color is this?
Green.
Green. So what do you think? The vowel sound in this?
E.
Yes, it's one of the easy ones, actually, when you say E, easy, but it's green. So when you see this color, you're going to think E, okay? Now we have another one here, this color. And I won't make you guess because it can be a little bit difficult. But what I needed to do was come up with a color that stands for ah.
Ah.
Ah. Ah. Most people in the languages that they've grown up with have this sound in their language, ah. And this I used, the color that I call auburn.
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 Yes, yes, yes. And if you look at Masako's hair, it is kind of a auburn color, you know, because it's a little bit reddish, isn't it? Auburn. Now that's the name of that. So when you see this color, you're going to be thinking, ah. What's the name of this color?
Orange.
Exactly. And I said, okay, this is the one that I want people to think of, oh.
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 Oh. I could have come up maybe with oh something else, I'm not sure, but it's orange. Orange.
Orange.
Orange. Okay, now we're going to get into a couple of other little ones here. This color?
Blue.
Blue, exactly. And the vowel sound, you think?
Ooh.
Ooh, exactly. Ooh, ooh. I will tell you the name of this color because it is something that every artist knows when you're cleaning your brushes at the bottom of the water or the bottom of the can, when you're cleaning brushes. All the colors come together and they make up this word called mud.
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 If you're playing outside in the dirt and you put water in dirt, it turns to mud. Yeah? So the color I came up with to represent that sound, is mud. Yeah, and that's one of the words or sounds in English that is used all of the time. All of the time. It's the very relaxed sound, so we'll work on that. How about this color? What color is this?
Pink.
Yes. And the sound that I want you to remember for this one is eh. Eh. Yeah. It's kind of like if you're looking at my face, it looks like eh. You know, like I'm going eh. Doesn't. But we say this color or this sound in many words also, and we'll talk about that a little bit. We have a very short time to talk about this, but you're going to learn these sounds and what the colors help you with when you look at words. What color is this?
Black.
Black, yes, black. And in American English, that sound, ah, is something that I want you to really remember. It's that another sound that we use all of the time. Ah.
Ah.
Ah. Exactly. Now I have two other sounds and colors that a lot of classes will not teach you as vowels. But I call them vowels because, again, remember I said earlier I was talking about singing, and it's just elongated speech. You know, you say take a long time with it. Well, if you're going to talk, you have to do it in the same way that you would if you're singing. So here is a color that you use all the time in English, actually. What is it?
Purple.
Purple. It's not easy to say. It is not easy to say at all, but we use it all of the time. And the first sound, the first vowel sound is er. Er. That's what I want you to remember. It's that American er. Oh, and it's going to be an interesting time to practice this one, because that er, and again, remember I'm saying vowel sound. Okay? Now again, another one here. What's this color?
Yellow,
exactly. And the vowel sound, again, it's not the e in yeah, eh. It's the o. It's the o. Because the L in a lot of words is like a vowel sound. You have to completely forget what you've learned about the tongue and wherever it is, but you have to put your tongue up behind your teeth and then make this really loud, just a sound. Oh.
Oh.
Oh. Perfect. I mean, you just sound beautiful. And you'll see that oh sound, even though it may not be comfortable for you, it is something that's really important to learn. So when you learn these 10 vowel sounds and what they represent, you'll be able to see in this method how these colors work. Okay. I'm sure you've noticed, and you might even have been using them too. We use these 10 colors. The colors red stand for eh. Green, E. Auburn, ah. Orange, blue, mud, good. Pink, eh. Yeah, that's better. Black, and it's ah. Yeah, the ah sound. Now here we go with the purple. What sound is that? Very good. Oh, I like that. And then yellow, what's the sound? Yes. Oh, yes. Okay. So what we're going to do is practice. We don't even have to do that. Now the next thing I want you to do, because I still am using paper and pencil here, is you take your colored pencils, okay, because this is another way to actually remember something, is a little bit of, you're going to see those colors at the top of the screen, or the top of the page, the same ones. And I want you to take those colored pens, and I want you to color in the first one, red. You find your red pen. Okay. Everybody have their red pen? Okay. And you're going to color that little block there, because I want you to remember what those colors are. When you take this sheet home with you, you're going to be able to, and you have yours already, yes. Okay, did you get one? More? Yeah. So just color in your red square. Okay, then do the next one is green. Color that in, green. And think to yourself while you're doing that. Think the color. Put the red up there in the square. Okay, like this. Ooh. You have the red up there in that little square. Right? Yeah, go with the red. Red, red, red. Not red. You have it? Good, good. Okay, you're all done with the red. Then go with the green. Good. Next is the green. You got the green? Good. Okay, and next is, okay, and this one is the auburn. Okay, it's a little bit tricky. That's why I'm watching over you. Auburn is the third one down. And then, of course, you have the fourth one is orange. Got that? Oh. Think to yourself when you're coloring. So you say, oh, oh, oh. Oh, oh, oh. Exactly. And then the next one, of course, is blue. Blue, color that in. Color that in so you see that. Excellent, excellent. What good students you are. Next one is mud. Here's your mud color. Yeah, see your mud color? Yeah. Did you get the mud color? Sometimes they're kind of difficult. Good, you got that. Good, good, good. Okay, mud. Then you have pink, right? Pink. It's almost like you're saying pit, like ih, or it, or is, or any of those short little ih sounds. Then the last one is ah, right? Like ah, right? Okay. And then those other ones, the toughies, ol and er. Ol and er. Okay. So we're going to practice a little bit more with those. But those 10 colors are all you need to speak American English. Trust me. What I want to do now is look at a list of words. And I have made copies of this screen for you. And of course, when we get our app done, you'll be able to use this yourself on the app. If you could take one and pass it around and get those people also. These are all your 10 vowel sounds with using all the consonants. Now, today we won't be able to go into consonants. But we are talking about vowels. Thank you. And I have talked to you about a philosophy of vowels and why, how I came up with this program. But it's also something that a classically trained singer has known for a very, very long time. And that is that the vowels are what carry the message to the listener. It's the vowels, just like when you're singing, it's those vowels that a person will hear when you're saying something. The consonants have to be there. Well, maybe, maybe not. But they do, because they clarify the message. And I'm sure you've known that already, because you're here and you're, by the way, I have to tell you, you are very brave people. I think it the courage that it takes to live in a country where people might say to you, huh? Or, what did you say? I've been there myself. I've been there and tried to live in countries where I didn't speak the language very well. And I realized, oh my gosh, I really have to be brave and just do it. So I really honor, I'm honored that you're here to learn and be, because I know you're courageous. I know you're courageous. So, anyway, let's look at these words on this page. And we're just going to do a few little drills. We'll start with the eh sound, because the eh is something that's not really that difficult. But when you go home and you want to practice these vowel sounds, you're going to want to, if it's a difficult vowel sound for you, you're going to want to just go straight down the list. Okay? Like, I'll say it and you repeat, please. Bed.
Bed.
Pep.
Pet.
Zen.
Zen.
Said.
Said.
Then.
Then.
Threat.
Threat.
Dead.
Dead.
Test.
Test.
Vet.
Vet.
And the letter F.
F.
Get.
Get.
Men.
Men.
Net.
Net.
Jet.
Jet.
Check.
Check.
Chef.
Chef.
Hem.
Hem.
When.
When.
Next.
Next.
Exempt.
Exempt.
Interesting, huh? I love those words. Okay, now we're going to do a little bit of difficult words here, because I want you to get the flavor of how this works, these colors and what they're doing for you. We're going to look at the R column, okay? The way we say that letter has nothing to do with the way we're pronouncing it. So remember what the purple sounds like, what the vowel sound is?
R.
Exactly. It's R. So when we look at that first word, we're looking at bird.
Bird.
Yeah, just bird. Mm-hmm. Bird. You say the consonant and then you say the single vowel sound and there you are. The second one, purr.
Purr.
Okay, third one is a two-syllable word, but this, it's the ending, user.
User.
Yes, sir.
Sir.
And then mother.
Mother.
Thirst.
Thirst.
Dirt.
Dirt.
Turn.
Turn.
Server.
Server.
Fervor.
Fervor.
Now, you know, when we're saying this, if you could just, your mouth is going to stay right in the same position because it's and then your tongue is going to move to get the consonants there. Okay? Then the after fervor, it's gird.
Gird,
yeah, make sure you're doing the okay? Hanger.
Hanger.
Murder.
Murder.
Nurse.
Nurse.
Journey.
Journey.
Church.
Church.
Pleasure.
Pleasure.
Shirt.
Shirt.
Hurt.
Hurt.
Oh, little mistake, sorry. Her.
Her.
If it's H-E-R, how would you pronounce it? H-E-R?
Her.
Her, exactly. Okay, and oh, look. Look at the next word. Okay, so we have er in this word. Er. Yeah. Now, if you can think about this, look, your first sound, what's the first sound? Eh, yeah. So you can see the color is red, right? So it's eh. So we have eh, er. Well, I may as well tell you now. There's something in American English and probably a lot of other, whoops. Do you know this word? Diphthongs are two sounds. Okay, and a diphthong is something like if you were going to say this letter, you actually have to use two sounds to say it. Same with this. This letter. Yeah, you are using two sounds. This is what a diphthong is. So this letter is the E and the E. A.
A.
If you're saying this letter, if you notice on your printout here, the little I is green, isn't it? The background color is auburn. Yeah? So the foreground, yeah, so you have, you use those two sounds to say this. And in chromatics, in the program chromatics, it will come up with the two different colors. So it will help you say the word, well, what we have here, because we're going to be pronouncing this like the name of that letter, I, yeah? I.
But golden color comes first, I mean, this time, blonde is first.
Well, what color is that?
Auburn.
Auburn, exactly, it's ah. Yeah, the ah is the first thing, ah, 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 ah. Because what is the difference between ah and er? Because when we're doing this color here, we have in our vowel sounds, we've got the e, right, is this. We've got the er here, right, the e, er. And now we've got that other vowel that we have to say, and it's two of them. It's I.
I.
Perfect. Perfect. So e, er, I. Perfect. Yeah. So the e or I. Those are the three vowel, the three syllables in that word. And if you say those three vowel sounds, e or I, by the way, I used to say something like at you er a oo, at you er a oo. Do you know this song? Happy birthday to you. It's what I recommend in practicing these. If you're going to practice a whole speech, you say the vowels only. A, I, R, A, U, U. So you go from vowel to vowel to vowel when you're saying that. So these words, you can actually say E, R, I. Because remember, the vowels are what we are listening for. The consonants, just clarify it. Exercise, but it's E, R, I. And you got to remember the vowel sounds, the vowel sounds. Okay, so the last word on this list is two syllables, exert. Yeah? Exert. Exert. Yeah. We won't go into meaning right now because you have to, your vocabulary is what you rely on. You know you're going to use your own vocabulary to learn the English, of course. Now let's go with the L sound. Oh boy, remember? What is this color?
Yellow.
And the sound it makes?
L-O.
Yeah, stick your tongue up behind your teeth and go, oh.
Oh.
Exactly, that's perfect. Okay, so when we go down this list, let's see if I can get it up. Just take a look at that and you can see that it's just the consonant and the one vowel. So you are going to go from B, you know, the B of the bull, of the B sound, to O. Immediately you go from B to O. And so, yes, those two sounds, bull.
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 That's it. You don't have to worry about anything else, just those two sounds. The next word, pull.
Pull.
Just those two sounds. The O, the way you have it, so it goes from P to O. Pull.
Pull.
Pull. Yeah. Pull. Do you feel it? There's another little axiom in singing is you're never supposed to listen to yourself, so you're supposed to feel how it sounds. You know, and how you're supposed to be saying that, you feel it in your mouth. You feel it in where your lips are going and where your tongue is going. So think about how it feels so you'll be able to do it again. Okay, let's go down here. Now we have a two-syllable word. The first. How do you say that next word down there? Anybody? Yeah, yeah. So you have the one syllable. The first one is, can anybody guess what vowel sound it is? Yes, 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 yes. And what color is
Mud.
Mud. Ah, yeah. Ah is auburn, and is mud, mud, So we have puzzle. That's it. Puzzle. 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 Yeah, and be sure that when you use that L, and if we had another whole hour or so, we would go ahead and practice that O, because you go right from Z to O. Like you would say Zl.
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 See, I'm not even opening my mouth. And you can actually, that's why you have these mirrors, right? Okay, you can look at yourself and say, Zl.
Zl.
Yes, because you do have to do the Z. Zzz, and then you get your tongue. You know, you're going to have your tongue right behind the top of your teeth. Zl.
Zl.
Yes, exactly, exactly. So you have to remember that. Let's on the next one. Pencil.
Pencil.
Pencil. Well, remember now, don't look at the letters. Don't think about how you used to pronounce it. Just look at the color and say, I know that's a s sound, but then it's a ol. Ol. So now you're just going to do sul.
Sul.
Yes. So this one is pencil.
Pencil.
Yes, perfect. I mean, you sound wonderful. You have to ignore that I there. You have to just say, that doesn't exist. I'm just going for the ol. Okay, and then the next word, ethyl.
Ethyl.
Mm-hmm. Sandal.
Sandal.
Yes. turtle?
Turtle.
See? Because now we have the t-ol, t-ol. And it's only toll. That's all it is, toll. Okay? Now the next one, oh boy. Now we're thinking eh and ol, right? Because we know it's going to be one syllable, we eh. Then we go in the last syllable, vol, vol. So you're going to start out with that little consonant that goes really quickly, because the purpose of a consonant is just clarify that vowel sound, and you're going to go right into the vowel sound, eh, le,
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 le.
And then you're going to say vol,
vol,
vol, vol. It's kind of like the same thing you would say with awful,
awful,
awful. Yeah. The only vowel sound there is ol, so you go right from to all, full.
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 Yeah, don't worry about full, but full.
Full.
Yeah, right into all. So all those words there, we're going to go on and work on difficult words in a minute, but I want you to know how to use these lists. Just like with all of them are mainly the vowel sounds, and you go boop, 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 so you, and you think, how does this feel? You can even record yourself and say, is this what I'm sounding like? Is it really the eh? Is it really the ah? Kind of thing, okay? Because there is definitely those differences. What I want to show you now, and hand this out. Don't look at your lists, okay? Don't look at your lists. I'm going to say a word. You get your cards out. I want you to get your cards out. And I will be, let's see, what shall I do? We'll go with words that sound with an or we'll do it with an ah, or we'll do it with an ah, okay? So you have these three cards out, and I want you to listen to the word I say, and I want you to hold up the card when you know what it is, okay? Now, so if I said pop, 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 pop. This is one of the things that you're going to want to do also when you go out after this class. You're going to want to listen and say, what color is that? And when you think, oh, I have to drop my jaw to say this, ah, like ah, isn't that cute? Ah, that is so wonderful. Ah, I have to drop my jaw to say it, so I'm going to be using auburn, yeah? Auburn, auburn, this one. Auburn, auburn, exactly. That ah sound, okay? So then how about this one? If I said us, us, us. Oh, you got it! Yes, that color is this one. It's that sound, that you know. Sometimes I always think duh, you know, just like you know. So, because it's a very, very relaxed sound. Where your tongue is in your mouth, it's right in the middle. So you're saying for us, us. Okay, how about, well, I don't want you to, okay, so how about am I dropping my jaw? See, I'm mixing it up, isn't it? You know, just trying to trick you. No, just it's interesting to try and see what color is that. And we have us, right? Like us and bus and other things. How about the number one? One vowel sound. One. This is another one. One, when? Whoa. Yes, it's the mud again. It's the mud again. You know, I'm driving it into the ground here. Mud, okay?
Could you pronounce this one again?
Any takers? Ah. Drop your jaw. Ah, perfect. Yeah, drop your jaw. Ah, yeah. It's like, you know, when you go to the doctor and the doctor wants to stick that thing in your mouth, say ah. Yeah, it's that. It's that one. Ah. Yeah. Okay, so now if I said cat. Good. Yep. Yep. Cat. Yeah, cat. How about father? Just the first syllable. Father. 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 Yes, it's Auburn, 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 Auburn. Father. How about song?
Song.
Song. Song. Look at me. Song. Exactly, exactly. You got to drop your jaw to say that, don't you? Song. So it is Auburn. It's Auburn. Yep. It does get confusing sometimes, but you'll get it. How about, what is the name of this thing? Not the chin, but
jaw.
Exactly. And that's that sound. It's ah, jaw. Yeah, that's that sound. Exactly. Okay. This is one of these reasons why in this word here and this word here, it's ah. It's ah. Yeah, it's going to be ah. So when this comes up in your Chromatics app, it will say just Auburn color. Ah, ah. Ah. Ah, ah. Ah, just one sound, yeah. Yeah, this one, ah. If you were going to say both syllables, ah, you'd have those two sounds, ah, but they're pure. Ah, ah, mm-hmm. Okay, now I'm going to hand out just, and we won't practice a lot of these, but these are the diphthongs, okay? Like ah, or a, and I. So when we're talking about diphthongs, it takes two sounds to say the name of this letter. It takes two sounds to say the name of this letter. It also takes two sounds to say the name of this letter. Okay, so let's go back here to this one. Okay, now, just what is the name of this letter?
R.
Yes, perfect. And what you are doing, of course, is starting out with ah and er. So you say both sounds in order to say this letter name. R, R, R. Because, do we have anything on our difficult list here? No. That word.
Car.
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 You have to say ah,
ka,
er. Car.
Car.
Yes, car.
Car.
Car. That's it. That's it. That's it. But you must remember, you have to say those two sounds. Car, car, car. How about this? What's the name of this letter?
L.
Yes, and you start out by saying right? And then you continue with the L. It's the vowel sound, L. L. Remember, stick your tongue behind your teeth, at the top of your teeth. So then you go L.
L.
Exactly. Very, very good. Okay. What's the name of this letter?
U.
Exactly. And to say this, you must start with, believe it or not, this.
E.
E. Yeah. And then you go into this one. Ooh. So you start out with U and then go into U. 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 Yeah. Those two sounds. Okay, that's it. Thank you very, no, I'm kidding. That's it, but this is all you need to know. The 10 vowel sounds, and if you can learn to hear them and to say them, just remember, it's. I'll give you a lot of handouts. Did I give you the diphthong handouts already? Yes. Your diphthong handout. The first word there, babe, yeah? Babe, because you're saying A-E, babe, babe, babe. If we go to the I column, the next word there is buy, isn't it? Buy, like you're going to buy something. So you're saying buy, 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 that's it. Okay, if we go to the next one, those are not too difficult. The oi, 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 like boy or soy or toy. But you do need to do the o, the oi. Okay, now the one we had here, well, we did have this. What was that word? One of you had that had au in it. Au. Because let's look at au. Yeah, seriously. We had a and u. Au. Before class we were talking about difficult words. Au, au. Well, this one, like town, town, if you're doing that one. Downtown, downtown. You really, when you're relearning and you're training yourself to change old habits, make sure that you're doing the ah and the ooh. The two sounds there, just like it says on the list. The first word there, bounce, bounce. So if you look at this word, okay, oops. One day I'll figure this out. You have the ah first, don't you, on bounce, and then the ooh, ah ooh, ah ooh. So your next word, pound, pound, those two vowel sounds. A-u, a-u, and all the way down. Like, where do you live? In a house? A-u, a-u, house. Okay, your very first word up here, what color?
Black.
Black, right, exactly. So the color behind that letter tells you to say what vowel sound?
Ah,
yeah, ah. So when you look at that and you look at the color, you know you're going to say axe, right? Axe. And look at the second word. What color is that?
Auburn.
Auburn, yeah. Auburn. Yeah. So you have, you know that it's going to be ox.
Ox.
Ox. Ox, perfect. Ox. Look at the next word. C-A-U-S-E. It's only ah, remember? So you're going to say cause, 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 exactly. Whoops, I'm using wrong color. This is cause, right? Because it's Auburn. Yeah, ah. But this next word, you can't look at what it's spelled like. What's the vowel sound, you think? Yes. Yes. This one is Auburn, cause. This one is because, because, Cuz. You have you ever seen this word? Cuz. C-U-Z. Sometimes people write it like this. Just cuz. I'm doing this just cuz. Cuz. So you have this sound. It's the same one. Because.
Cuz.
Yeah, that's it. Cuz. Because. What is the difference between cause and cuz? Cause, you have to is cuz. Perfect. Yes. And if you yes? Because if you drop your jaw, cause, I'm going to cause this to work. Or I'm doing it because my jaw is not down very much. It's cuz. Just a little bit. Down a little bit. Okay? So, what else do we have on here? Food is pretty easy, huh? Look at the next one. Girl. And I want you to remember those are just two vowel sounds. Where's er? And ol. So you're going to be saying only ol. Because remember, this one is ol, right? Ol. Girl. That's it. You sound like me? Girl. How about this one down there that's on the list? A little bit farther down. That's it. It's only this sound, only this. Work. Yeah. What about this one? Just one sound, that's right. It's this one.
Walk.
Exactly, it's walk. That's it. Have you ever used this to cook? You ever use that? They are pronounced exactly the same. Walk. Exactly the same. Okay, how about this is tricky. We haven't used this color.
Warm.
Yes, it's O-er is the vowel. Two vowel sounds, O-er, and that's what you have to remember. Warm, yeah. Yeah. The W you don't have to worry about. Just get your mouth around. Warm. Yeah. Just like this word, huh? Same thing. War. Yeah, war. So again, it may not look like it this one here may not look like it sounds like that, but that's that little thing that is wandering around, right? Worm. So don't look at how it is spelled. Remember, oh no, it's worm. And only the color you have to remember. Okay. So now what we're going to do is go through your difficult list because you've got it. Right? You know how to do this. And if you want to, when we go through this, you can write down these words. Use your pens if they're not on the list already. And you can color them yourself. And I'm going to take my pens all the way down here. Okay. And we're going to say, let's hope this works. We already know what color is this? Ah. Yeah, it's auburn. Auburn. Now, to say this word, you have to say autumn. Autumn. And it really is just, there's not much to it, but it is kind of a mud color sound. And I'm sorry, I don't have a real mud. You know, one of these days maybe I'll get a maid or something. But autumn, autumn. Or when you get the app, you will be learning this just by the colors. So here we have autumn. How about this one?
August.
Yes, and it's the same thing. The and the August. 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 Okay, and we've already done exercise, right? So we have right? And remember, I, ah, and E. So you have four vowel sounds in that one word. That's one of the reasons why it's a little difficult. Because I, exercise. I. I. I'm going to be not going straight down. What I want you to see, this word here has the same vowel sound. Same letters by chance, but a, right? Am, am. What's that color? A. Eh? Eh. Eh, yeah, black, black. So we have a. Track.
Black.
Black, yeah. Ah. So we have Amtrak. Amtrak. Those are your two vowel sounds. Amtrak. The next word here. We know it's got this vowel sound, right? And the first, surprise, the first vowel sound is eh. So we go eh, oh, just like the name of the letter, L, L. So we have well. Perfect. So what you need to do is focus on that vowel sound. Whoops, that yellow doesn't work very well. How about this one? That's better. The W just gets you started, okay? So well, now how about this one? What do you think the vowel sound is? It's one vowel sound.
Over.
Almost. Not quite. What's the name of the letter there? What's the name of this letter?
A.
A. Uh-huh, and A is a diphthong, right? So we have e, e, a, e, a,
way,
way,
way.
Exactly. So it's like you're saying W-A-Y, way, way, but you're doing e and e, and then you go with the o. Whoops. Okay, because in this case, L is a vowel. I want you to think, that's how you say that. Perfect. E, E, O. Remember to put your tongue behind your teeth. O. Whale. 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 Perfect. Yes. Yes. If you're drinking ale, you know. Or if it's hailing, you're doing the A, okay? Real. Eel. Eel. Think of the vowel sounds. Eel. What do you think? What do you think? Eel.
Green.
Green. Green. Yeah. Whoops. Where's my, what happened to, oh, look what I did. Okay. So we have E. E and O. That's it. Okay, so we have eel, real, and then the last syllable, really? What's the last syllable? E? Really? E-E-E. Green. Really, 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 really. Now, there are times, and this is another lesson entirely, but there are times when you will hear this pronounced really, like I, ri, ri, ri. But don't worry about it tonight. If pink is there, you're going to say I, ri, li. Real, real, real. E, really, really. Okay? Like here, then in this word, li, it's pink. Li, li, litter. I-er, I, I-er, E. I-er, where's my purple? Litter, litter, O, and E. That's it. In green. It-er-oli, literally, literally. Don't worry about the consonants, just make sure you've got those vowels in your head. It-er-oli, ear-oli. Yes, see how that T clarifies it? Literally, yeah, literally. Okay, just like this one now. Seriously. Sear, sear, sear. Oy, you have some complicated ones here. I, that's pink, sorry. Sear. Sear. What's the next one? E, sear. Sear, E. Sear, E. Mud, mud, serious. So you have a lot of them there. E, I, er, e, I, er, e, This is why it is a difficult word. Si, er, e, Serious, serious, serious. Yeah, and this is when you need to practice. Go home and say all these vowel sounds together. I, er, e, Serious. Serious. This is serious business. Seriously. Seriously. Lee. Yeah, because you have an E on the end here, right? Seriously. Yep. Okay, and we have one. McDonald's you'll get. I don't worry about them. It's this other one here. Oh, boy. Okay, the first vowel sound you're looking for is this one. And then, that's it. You see what? I don't know why English has all those letters in there, but there are only two vowel sounds. O. O. That's it. Earl. Because here, this, what you think is a vowel, it's not, it's a consonant. And it functions like a W, doesn't it? It functions like a W. So it's were, squir, squir. Yeah, because you're doing these consonants here. Sk. And W is just a shape in your mouth, that's all it is. Sk, were, squir, squir, o. Squir, o. Squirrel.
Squirrel.
Yeah. You just do the oh. Squirrel. Yes. You'll be able to use this on any tablet. Jeff, laptop also, you think? Tablet, laptop, anything, Android, Apple. Whatever you want. You use your own words. You can import your own text and practice. You can import individual words, and it will come up with the color behind it. And in case you forget, we've got the little color cues up in the corner for you. Okay? And if you want to, then you'll be able to save it. You'll be able to translate this without letters. Now, this is what I want to recommend to you guys, too, because if you can somehow not look at the letters when you practice this, because just like with the letter we, that's pretty simple. You say this all the time. E is a green, so you can say we. Go, O for orange, O. It's pretty simple. But when you get into maybe that one word at the end of the sentence there, life, life, you want to make sure you're doing those two sounds, ah, E, ah, E. Okay? Okay? Questions? What do you think?
Good.